100 years ago, not only the fate of Poland, but also of Europe was at stake. The clash of two worlds took place on Polish soil. Only a dozen months after regaining independence, Poles again took up arms to defend their country. Their victory decided about Poland's independence and stopped the spread of the communist revolution over Western Europe. As we fought, major European countries demonstrated indifference and even hostility. In that war, Poland was supported only by France and Hungary and volunteers from several countries. The 11th of November 1918 was a breakthrough day in the history of Poland and the whole of Europe. World War I was over. After 123 years of occupation, Poland regained its independence. The borders of the independent Polish state were established by the Treaty of Versailles, signed on the 28th of June 1919 at the International Peace Conference in Paris. Eventually, after plebiscites and three Silesian uprisings, the western, northern and southern borders were established. Only the eastern border with Soviet Russia still remained disputable. Finally, it was delineated as a result of the Polish-Bolshevik battles. The war with Soviet Russia was led by the newly formed state, whose citizens had been until then separated by the three partitioning countries, Russia, Prussia and Austria. The young republic was just struggling to build its economic and administrative systems. The turning point in the Polish-Bolshevik War was the Battle of Warsaw, which took place on the outskirts of Warsaw, called the Miracle on the Vistula River, and considered the 18th most decisive battle in world history. The key roles on the Polish side were played by Józef Piłsudski, Tadeusz Rozwadowski, Józef Haller and Władysław Sikorski. In July 1920, the Council of National Defense decided to establish a volunteer army under the command of General Józef Haller. Everyone joined: workers, school and university students, members of the Women's Voluntary Legion, voluntary state police formations, the Citizens' Guard, priests, over 100,000 soldiers in total. Father Ignacy Skorupka, a volunteer chaplain from the 236th Volunteer Army Infantry Regiment, was killed in the Battle of Ossuf. Józef Piłsudski successfully outmaneuvered the Soviets, which was of great significance for the victory of the Poles. One of the few diplomats who remained in the threatened Warsaw was the papal nuncio Akilerati, the future Pope Pius XI. In August 1920, the British Secretary of State for War and Air, Winston Churchill, said, "Poland has saved herself by her exertions and will, I trust, save Europe by her example." This war was a clash of two opposing visions of civilization. One was represented by the orderly world of Christian tradition with its centuries-old cultural and scientific heritage, human rights, freedom of speech, parliamentary democracy. The other was the Bolshevik dictatorship, which made the violation of all norms and principles a goal and object of glory. On the 18th of March 1921, the Treaty of Riga was signed. This ended the Polish-Bolshevik War. The established border remained unchanged until 1939.